Hi, Ashley.
Hi, Dr. Jill. Good to see you again.
Yeah, and it's nice to see everybody online again.
Yes, for sure. It has been a while, but we are back in this way. And Dr. Jill, I think you have kind of a special lesson prepared for us ahead of the weekend if people are looking for some outdoor activities.
Yeah. Ashley, do you like gardening?
I am starting to feel confident in my gardening skills. I enjoy it, but I don't always have good luck.
I've been spending a lot of time lately in my garden because I don't have to drive around anymore. So
yeah, don't have to go anywhere but your garden.
Yeah. And because it's a little difficult to get out to the market and to find what I want in the market, it's really nice to be able to grow my own food. I think a lot of people are thinking in that way these days. Mm-hmm. And so they're starting to plant gardens. The problem is, if you don't have a big piece of land, how can you garden? Well, right. The answer is container gardening. It's where you grow things in a pot. It doesn't have to be a huge pot, but you can have smaller pots. And you can even grow things indoors if you have the light coming in through windows.
Yes, having the correct light is, I think, my problem.
Yeah, I think you live in a shady area, right?
I have a big tree that kind of blocks a lot of sunlight, which is good in the summer, keeps everything cool, but it also does not give a lot of good light to plants.
Right. Yeah. So we have some tips for you.
Oh, good.
I did a story with our colleague Ana Mateo about container gardening, and I want to share that with everyone today. Let me show you the title of that article. People want to look on our website and find it. It's called Fight Tension and Boredom with a Container Garden. And there's a little tiny URL down there. If you just can copy the last section of that and go to tinyurl.com and put it in, so you should be able to find it. Or you can look on our website in the health and lifestyle section.
Exactly.
So again, as you know, people are stuck at home, they're looking at something that's relaxing to do. And the research has shown that growing your own vegetables or food is a very good way to relieve stress. So we're all looking for ways to do that these days. Mm-hmm. We have a couple of questions for our audience. Do you have any pots and any plants in pots inside your house? How about you, Ashley?
I have one or two. I have one big plant that I bought from a garden center a few years ago because I thought the air in my apartment was making me sick. So I went online and searched for different kinds of plants you can have indoors to help keep the air clean.
Yeah.
But I think it is called an
Sorry.
It is an areca palm.
Oh, good. A palm.
Yeah.
So it has big leaves that hang over.
Very big leaves. It's getting too big for the inside.
Yeah. Is it touching the ceiling?
No, not yet.
You don't eat that plant, right?
I do not. I do not think it can be. Maybe it can be used to make things. I feel like people around the world probably use this type of plant to make different things. But no, I don't think you can eat it. I don't want to try.
Usually when people grow plants inside the house, they don't eat them, unless maybe it's an herb. Mm-hmm. How about plants growing in pots outside of your house? Do you have any plants like that?
Personally, I just planted some. So I am trying to grow tomatoes in pots, cucumbers, a pepper plant, and Brussels sprouts, but I think it is, I think I planted it in the wrong time for that. Yeah. They grow
in cooler weather.
Yeah, they are doing very well. I planted them in April, but now I think I'll maybe bring them indoors. I don't know what I will do.
Yeah, so when people grow plants outside their house, often it's something that they can eat. And that's what we're going to talk about today, is growing plants that you can eat outside of your house.
Great.
I have a nice photo here that is from England. It's a very tiny yard behind someone's house. And you can see there are all kinds of containers here. Some that look like boxes, some that look like old tires.
Mm-hmm.
I had a container like that made from a tire turned inside out. There's old barrels, wash tubs, buckets.
I have a neighbor who lives two streets away. And I walk by and she always has such interesting containers with herbs and flowers mm-hmm. growing in them, including rain boots.
A boot. Yeah.
Yeah, children, like little children's rain boots uh-huh. and a grill.
Mm-hmm.
And what else? Just all sorts of things. It's very cute how she has it displayed.
Yeah. I have a picture later I can show you of an old shopping bag I use for a container.
Mm. Everyone has those.
Yeah. So when you are thinking about growing in containers, you have to ask yourself, do I have sun or shade? Is there a lot of sun? Full sun is about 6 hours a day of sun shining on the plants. We have a nice rule of thumb. Have you ever heard of this, Ashley?
I would like you to explain rule of thumb as well.
my green thumb here from the gardener, right? So a rule of thumb, I guess it's where you used your thumb to measure, right?
Yeah, that's where it comes from. It used to be used as a measurement.
Yeah. If you eat the fruit or the root of the plant, it needs full sun. So mm-hmm. that would mean something like tomatoes, eggplant, peppers, squash, potatoes, or carrots. And you can see in this photo, somebody has lined up a bunch of trash cans with tomatoes.
Wow, that's a lot of soil.
It looks like a sunny side of their home. Yeah, so perfect. That's one way to grow things if you don't have the garden space in the ground. If you eat the leaves of the plant, that can grow in partial sun or shade, as we mentioned, shade. That includes things like broccoli, cauliflower, probably Brussels sprouts, because it's a kind of cabbage, right? Mm-hmm. You eat the leaves. Beans, beets, kale, salad greens. Do you like kale?
I am growing kale.
Me too.
In a raised bed, but uh-huh. it is not doing well.
Oh,
so maybe you can help me out with that.
Uh-huh. Yeah, are the rabbits eating it?
I think it has little bugs like aphids.
Mm, yeah, they like kale.
So,
and then you can also grow some herbs like mint, cilantro, thyme in partial sun.
Okay,
mint grows very well no matter where you put it. I think. Goes crazy.
Yeah. It's delicious for drinks or foods.
Right.
You can't have too much mint.
Right. So the other thing we can consider is what will grow in the space that you have. You probably have a balcony if you're in a high-rise apartment, maybe just windows. In some homes, there's maybe a porch, a deck. How about your house, Ashley? Do you have some space outside you can put
plants? I do have some space outside. The front of the house is very shaded, but there mm-hmm. are parts along the side that you can line up containers and grow in more
and
sunny
notice
areas.
You can go up too. You can use vertical space. Here, there's a some kind of a rack on the wall, and they've hung the pots on that. And that looks really pretty, I think.
It is so, it's very creative. People in small spaces can still have very bountiful gardens if they are creative.
Yeah. So you had mentioned earlier those big trash cans with the tomatoes. Mm-hmm. You said that's a lot of dirt.
I guess it, I said soil. Oh, I mean, soil. I might have said dirt, but yeah.
So when we grow things in containers, it's a good idea to put in a special mix that doesn't include regular garden soil.
Okay.
And do you know why? Can you imagine why that is?
Well, I can imagine that it would be very heavy to carry the container in regular dirt.
Right.
But also, it needs to be able to, the water needs to be able to drain or escape the pot.
Right, yeah. You want the water to go out of the pot. And you also want air to get to the roots. So and also you want to keep a little moisture, a little water in the soil, the mix, because if it gets too dry, then your plant gets dried out.
Yes. Yeah. Soil is extremely important. It's so important, and it is something I am trying to learn about. So I have more success this year and in the future.
Well, can I show you how I make my own mix?
Please.
My pots? All right.
Yes, Dr. Jill should be a doctor of gardening as well. She's very, very skilled.
So I use mostly three ingredients. The first one, you can see it's white and it's called perlite. It's like little tiny rocks. Or pieces, it's pieces of volcanic glass. And this is lightweight. And so it makes it so there's little bit air gaps in the in the mix for your plants. Lets the air get to the roots. The second one is compost. This is my favorite thing for the garden. Do you know where compost comes from?
Well, it can come from a lot of different things. Decomposing plants, old plants, leaves.
So, for example, in the fall, when people rake the leaves or collect them in one space, you'll see that after a few months, they go down, right? And they underneath, it looks very rich. It becomes rich soil. So that is where the food comes from for the plants. And the third one is peat moss. This is from a small plant that grows in very wet places. People collect it and dry it, and gardeners use it for the food for the plants and also to make the ground lighter, make the soil lighter. So I have buckets, a little bucket of each one here. I put it into a bigger bucket, equal amounts.
And then equal parts, all three. Okay.
Yep. And then I take a... this was a spade or a shovel. And before I mix it, I'm careful to put on a mask.
Well, we all have masks these days.
Right?
So another important use of it.
I bet all of our audience members have a mask now they could wear.
Yeah.
The reason is you don't want to breathe in the dust. It might irritate your nose or your lungs. So you want to wear a mask and then mix up this really well. One more thing I put in is just a scoop of ash. This is from what's left over from a fire. That gives a very important ingredient that is helpful to the plants. So at the end, you can see it's all mixed together, and that's what I call the soil-free mix. Doesn't that look good?
It does look good. It looks very healthy. Now, what about... I'm sure that wherever someone lives, the compost might be made of different plants.
Yeah.
Does that make a difference?
Not really, because the same things will break it down.
It's happening, yeah.
Yeah, so they're little bugs that eat it and make it into some fertilizer for the plants. Some people will use leftovers from animals. Let's say that.
Manure.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
A little more stinky.
Yeah. And actually quite rich, so maybe you would use a little less than you would for compost.
Right. Okay.
Yeah. Okay, so you've got your potting mix. What about what you're going to put it in? You mentioned earlier that your neighbor uses boots.
Old shoes, old containers, just anything.
Yeah. Here's a shopping bag. I think I got it at a conference. And I lined it up first, lined it with cardboard so it would stand up. And I put my soil-free mix in there. And I started some seeds of the flower, the morning glory, and I put them in there, and they're doing fine now out in
That's
my
so
garden.
Pretty. So this potting mix is good for vegetables, fruits, and flowers, right?
Yeah.
Just anything in a pot. Okay.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. You could use an old bucket or half of a barrel. These old barrels are really good. Air can come in through the sides. Mm-hmm. And you can put a hole easily in the bottom.
Yes, don't forget to put a little hole in the bottom of whatever you use.
Yeah.
So the water doesn't damage the roots.
Right, when it rains hard.
Yeah.
It might not be so good. So our final questions for you are, do you have a garden? And what do you like to grow?
I'm sure we'll get all sorts of interesting answers from people all over the world, because in some areas you can grow some types of fruits and vegetables, and other areas you can grow others. So
yeah, I would love to be able to grow tropical fruits.
I was going to say, you do grow some tropical. Can you just tell everyone what all you grow? Because I've told them the small amount that I try to grow, but let's hear it.
I have a lemon tree.
Lemon tree? That's so cool.
It's a Meyer lemon, which is a very round lemon that it's almost as sweet as an orange. It's a cross between the orange and a lemon. And I put it inside in the winter because it gets cold here.
Yeah, very cold.
And now it's outside enjoying the sun. I have avocado trees. I haven't gotten any avocados from them, but I have picked many lemons from my lemon tree. I'm also growing raspberries. Mm. And those are big black berries. And red ones, red. And blackberries. I have blueberries, and those are going to be ready probably in about a month. They're little white flowers now in the blueberries. Mm-hmm. I am growing elderberries, which is a bush with a lot of very rich little berries on them. Mm-hmm. Lettuce and kale, as we mentioned earlier. Grapes, I have grapes.
Wow.
I have hops. Which you can use to make beer.
Or other things, yeah.
Or there's a very relaxing tea you can make with hops.
Yeah.
And roses, and also butterfly bushes. I love butterflies, so I have a lot of butterfly bushes.
And are these herbs. All in the ground, or do you do container growing yourself?
Many of them are actually in containers.
Your trees are, because you bring them inside. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Okay.
Yeah. And the ones that are in the ground are usually in a kind of box, a raised bed box.
How long does it take before your avocado tree will produce fruit? I looked into this after you told me you had an avocado tree, and the internet told me 10 years.
Oh, okay.
I don't have time for that. I can't wait that long.
I have one that I think is about 6 years old.
Okay. So you're halfway there.
Maybe 8. Yeah. So when I get an avocado, I will invite you to come over for guacamole. Oh,
I don't think I would keep those for yourself. That's
But you could come over for lemonade when we are able to visit each other again.
Yes.
This summer I'll have lemons from my lemonade.
Lemonade, hops in it.
Well, I think our time is just about up. So are you ready to say goodbye?
Well, I suppose, yeah. Go check on our gardens. It is a very hot day today, so you have to be careful, like the containers are wet enough so the plants do not get stressed.
Yeah, it did rain a little last night
as well. Oh, it did? Oh.
Yeah.
So that's good.
Write to us, let us know what you are growing in your garden, and watch for another episode on Facebook.
All right. Thanks for joining us. We'll be back.
Bye-bye.
Bye.